Good morning. In this lecture, we discuss about the orthogonal basis and Gram-Schmidt process. So let V be an inner product space. A set S of vectors in a V is called an orthogonal basis of V if S is an orthogonal set and S is a basis for V. Further, an orthonormal basis S is an orthonormal basis for V if norm of V is equal to V1 for all V belongs to V a set S. For example, we have the standard basis in Rn is 1, 0, 0, 0, so on, means ith place having an element 1 and all the other elements having a 0. Like here in the first, A1 has the first element is 1, all the other elements are 0, A2 have the second element is 1 and all the other elements 0 and so on, is an orthonormal basis for the Rn. The set 1, 1 and minus 1, 1 is an orthogonal set in a R-square with respect to be a inner product. Say that the inner product of 1, 1 and minus 1, 1 we have. Applying the definition of inner product, we have 1 into the minus 1 and then 1 into 1 is equal to be 0. But this set is not an orthonormal set, because if we consider the norm of 1, 1, which is equal to be under root of 1 square plus 1 square, which is equal to be under root of 2, which is not equal to be 1. So one checks that for U, which is equal to be x1, x2 and V is equal to be y1, y2 belongs to be R square, the inner product of U and V, if it defined as x1, y1 minus the x2, y1 minus the x1, y2 plus 4 times the x2, y2 is an inner product in R square. Now with respect to with this inner product, the set 1, 1 and minus 1, 1 is not even an orthogonal set, because here the inner product of 1, 1 and minus 1, 1 is equal to be a 3, which is not equal to be 0. So we have to be very careful whatever the inner product we are going to be defined to be a set to be a orthogonal. So consider the set of all continuous real valued functions in the interval minus pi to pi, and V is an inner product space with respect to be an inner product f and g is equal to be 1 over pi integral minus pi to pi f of x into gx into dx. So with respect to with this inner product, the set sine of a nx, such that n belongs to be natural, is an orthonormal set. So for this, one can easily check that the integral minus pi to pi sine of a nx into sine of a mx dx is equal to be 1 when m is equal to be n, or it is equal to be 0 when m is not equal to be n. So every orthogonal set of a non-zero vectors in an inner product space is linearly independent. So let S be a finite or infinite set of a non-zero orthogonal vectors in the given space, and V1, V2, so on, Vm be a set of M vectors in S such that M is the less than equal to B dimension of a set S. So let V is equal to be alpha 1 v1, so on alpha m vm, and where the alphas belongs to be a field. For any k lying between 1 to m, the inner product of a v and vk is equal to be summation of alpha I inner product of a vi vk, which is equal to be alpha k into the inner product of a vk comma vk. Now since the vk is non-zero, the inner product of Vk comma Vk is non-zero. So the alpha k can be written as the inner product of V comma Vk over the inner product of Vk comma Vk. By the definition, so your inner product of vk comma vk is equal to be the norm of a vk square. So the alpha k is equal to be the inner product of v comma vk over norm of a vk square, where k is equal to be 1 to m. So if v is equal to be 0, then alpha k is equal to be 0 for k is equal to be 1 to m. Hence, S is a linearly independent set. So based on this, if S is an orthogonal basis for a V, whereas S is a set having one elements V1, V2, so on Vn, then for V belongs to as V, the set V, the kth coordinate of V is given by the inner product of a V comma Vk over the norm of Vk square. That is, if V is equal to be alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n, V n belongs to be V, then alpha k is equal to be the inner product of V comma Vk over the norm of Vk square. If V is an n-dimensional inner product space, then V can have at most n mutually orthogonal vectors. Now we discuss the Gram-Schmidt process. So Gram-Schmidt process was designed by the Schmidt in 1907. The orthonormal sequences are very convenient to work with. The remaining practical problem is how to obtain an orthonormal sequence if an arbitrary linearly independent sequence is given. So this is accomplished by a constructive procedure, the Gram-Schmidt process, for orthonormalizing a linearly independent sequence in an inner product space. The resulting orthonormal sequence has the property that for every n, the span of these orthonormal sequences E1, E2, so on, EN, the span of these linearly independent sequences X1, X2, so on, XN in a inner product space. So the first element is E1, which is equal to be X1 by norm of AX1. Then X2 can be written as X2 is equal to be the inner product of X2 comma E1 into the E1 plus V2. So V2 is equal to be, you can say that X2 minus the inner product of X2 comma E1 into the E1. It's not the zero vector, since these xi's is a linearly independent sequences. Also, this V2 is perpendicular to E1, since the inner product of a V2 comma E1 is 0. So that we can take E2 as a V2 by norm of a V2. Similarly, the vector 3, V3, is can be written as a X3 minus the X3 inner product of X3 comma E1 into E1 minus of inner product of X3 comma E2 into E2 is not the zero vector, and V3 is perpendicular to be E1 and V3 is perpendicular to be E2. So we can take E3 is equal to be V3 by norm of V3, and this process will be going. Thus, in the nth step, we observe the Vn is equal to be Xn minus summation of I is equal to be 1 to n minus 1 inner product of Xn comma Ei into Ei. Is a not the zero vector and is orthogonal to E1, E2, so on, En. And from it we can obtain En is equal to be Vn by norm of a Vn. Now if U and V belong to be inner product space X and V is a non-zero, then the vector U dot V over norm of a V square into V is called the vector projection of a U along a V. So let V be a vector inner product space, and the set V1, V2, so on, Vn be the set of a linearly independent vectors in a inner product space V. Then one can construct a set U1, U2, so on, Un of the orthogonal vectors from the set V1, V2, so on, Vn, which is the set of a linearly independent vectors, such that for any k lying between 1 to n, the set of U1, U2, so on, UK is a basis for the set of a linear span of the v1, v2, so on vn. So we can construct vectors u1, u2, so on un in the following way. So in the first step, we can choose the I is equal to b1 such that the ui is equal to vi. And then we can go with the increment I is equal to bi plus 1. If I is greater than n, then stop. Otherwise, the ui is equal to be the vi minus of a summation of j is equal to be 1 to I minus 1 vi uj over the norm of uj square into uj. So otherwise, again, we can go to the step number 3 and the process will be repeated up. Note here that the ui is non-zero. And then vi be a linear combination of a v1, v2, so on vi minus 1, which is not true. So next, we check that the set u1, v2, u2, so on un is a orthogonal set. So consider the u2, comma u1. So here the u2, by the definition, we have proved up that the u2 is equal to be v2 minus the inner product of a v2, comma u1 over the norm of u1 square, comma u1. So applying the definition of inner product, we have a v2 comma u1 minus of a inner product of a v2 comma u1 over norm of a u1 square into the inner product of a u1 comma u1. So here inner product of a u1 comma u1 is the norm of a u1 square. So this will be cancelled out. We get again the inner product of v2 comma u1. This will be cancelled with this. And this is equal to 0. So hence u1 and u2 are orthogonal. So in general, for any positive integer m less than or equal to n and r lying between 1 to m, we have inner product of a um plus 1 comma ur is equal to be the inner product of a vm plus 1 minus summation of a j is equal to be 1 to m inner product of a vm plus 1 comma uj into the uj over norm of a uj square comma ur. So on simplifying, we get inner product of a um plus 1 comma ur is equal to be the inner product of vm plus 1 comma ur minus the summation of a j is equal to be 1 to m inner product of vm plus 1 comma uj into the inner product of uj comma ur over the norm of uj square. So which is equal to be, now this will be again by j, so we are doing the summation from j is equal to be 1 to m, in between we have a r, so we get that this is equal to be inner product of vm plus 1 comma ur minus the inner product of a vm plus 1 comma ur. So here this will be cancelled and we get this is equal to be 0. So hence the set u1, u2, so on un is an orthogonal set. And next, for any k lying between 1 to n, these uis can be expressed as a linear combination of a vectors v1, v2, so on vk. Since ui is, this set is a linearly independent set, we get the u1, u2, so on uk is a basis for the set of a linear span of a v1, v2, so on v. Hence we get the result. So from the set v1, v2, so on vk, an orthonormal set of vectors v1, w1, w2, so on wk can be constructed as wi is equal to be ui over the norm of a ui. So every finite dimensional inner product space has an orthonormal basis. So consider, so we discuss now example based upon the Gram-Schmidt process and we will form up our orthonormal set. So consider R cube with a standard inner product and let V1 is equal to be 3, 0, 4 and V2 is equal to be minus 1, 0, 7. V3 is equal to be 2, 9, 11. And V1, V2, V3 is a linearly independent set of vectors in R cube. The first step of Gram-Schmidt process, we have a U1 is equal to be V1, which is equal to be 3, 0, 4. So now we can calculate the U2, which is equal to be V2 minus the inner product of a V2, comma U1 over the norm of a U1 square into U1. So here the V2 is equal to be minus 1, 0, 7. We can go with the inner product of a V2 comma U1 over the norm of a U1 square. So norm of a U1 square is like here, which is equal to be square root of a 3 square plus 0 square plus 4 square, which is equal to be 25. Now here we get inner product of a V2 comma U1, V2 comma U1. So we get the inner product of these two. inner product here is being defined as the standard inner product, means we have a minus 1 to 3 plus 0 into 0, 7 into 4. We get the answer here is a minus 25 over 25 into the u1. So u1 is 3 is into 0, 4. So we get the answer here is minus 4 comma 0 comma 3. And then we can calculate the u3, which is equal to be v3 minus the inner product over v3 comma u1 over the norm of a u1 square into u1 minus the inner product of v2 into u2 over the norm of a u2 square into u2. Again, on the similar lines, we can substitute all these values and get the answer is a 0, 9, 0. So now we get this set 304, minus 4, 0, 3, and third one is 0, 9, 0. So now this set, if you can check it out, the inner product of u1 into u2, or u1 into u3 or u2 into u3, we get the result is a orthogonal. So this set is a orthogonal set of vectors in a R3. And further, we have to be obtained orthonormal set from this set. So we can go only with the division of a norm of uis. So we can go with the u1 over norm of u1, u2 over the norm of u2, and u3 over the norm of a u3. So we get the vectors v1, v2 and v3. So this is the orthonormal set obtained, we get hence the result. So we get now these are the sum of the references. Thank you.